Hey there. In this video, we are going to talk about how to create a killer resume 0 to 1 path. Okay, so we are going to explain step by step things you have to add in your resume. And in the end, we are going to discuss 3 to 4 resume like this. Like, this is the guy who got selected in Amazon. This is the guy who got selected as a fresher in a data science profile. And this is one other the profile of a student who is a very good in development. So we are going to discuss, so stay tuned, watch the video till the end so that you don't miss anything important. Okay, so let's start with why resume is needed, like why every company asks for resume, why recruiters ask for resume, why I have to upload it, what is the need behind it. So recruiters evaluate a large number of applications, like thousands of applications for few openings. So they need some structure, some standard way so that they can compare lots of applications in a very short span of time. This also ensures that they have all the information that they required to make a decision, like the skill set required, like the projects made, like the exposure or any experience if the candidate has. So it serves a template for them. How a resume is made. So if you look at lots of resume, like I have looked at hundreds of resume over a period of time, so I can just tell by looking at resume how particular that guy is. So if you look at good students, their resume is well managed, well maintained, but a lot of students don't spend so much time in their resume. So it also serves as a preliminary evaluation tool, like you can see which student is good or which student is not relevant for your opening. Some jobs require strict legal criteria, so it helps to ensure candidates sworn by any info provided, like if you're working in the banking and fintech domain, so you need to do provide some background verification and all those things. So you need to provide your authentic address and all those things so that it can be verified. So make sure everything you add in your resume is true and correct. So let's discuss what are we going to discuss. So different stages of preparation we have divided into 5 stages on different functionalities or different information you have to add. The stage 1, you have to ensure your resume have the basic structure, like educational details, experience, projects, personal bio and school and all those things. So okay, we are going to discuss it in brief. Then stage 2, we will add what recruiters wish to see, like if you are applying for a software engineering profile, so you have to identify what recruiters are looking, and so that you only add those things what they are looking, like they are looking for some keywords, so we have to make sure those keywords are there in your resume. Stage 3 is to describe your experience professionally, specifically projects in this case as you are freshers. Okay, so we'll discuss how to do that. How to design is stage 4, not jazzy but elegant design. You don't have to use multiple colors, fonts, etc. We are going to talk it in stage 4 and some of the other considerations that you have to do. So let's start with stage 1. As I found, a lot of HRs have also pointed out more than 40% student don't add even the basic details required, which leads to rejection in earlier phases only. So you have to make sure you add your personal info, name, working mobile number. Lots of students have WhatsApp number or different numbers, so make sure a number that's able to call, your latest email ID, your bio, accurate educational details. So it's very important you add correct details of your 10th, 12th and college, because it's necessary for recruiters to identify whether you have a gap year or not. So your percentage year of appearing should be provided properly in a structure. We will discuss how to do that. Third is skills you are proficient in, internship, projects, that should also be added in a basic structure, like what skills, what like DBMS, DA, OOPS, Android, web, or anything you would like to add. Extracurricular activity only of college and not of school. So this will help a lot of students ask, sir, shall I add it or not? If it is something substantial, like you organize some event, you coordinated some activity, so you can add it. But only make sure you add it of college or not of any school. Okay, so let's look at the structure. So this guy has properly added his name, some details, profile links, skills properly. It's a single page resume. Okay, so you can look at that. Experience is added, education is added, 10th and 12th, both he has done from same college, so he has mentioned it here only. he has added his project. So this is the basic structure that you have to follow: achievements, hobbies, position of responsibility, certification, and another resume you can look at. So this is also another structure that you can follow. He has provided his basic details, links, profiles. So a lot of students miss out on adding their profile links to LinkedIn, CodeChef, GitHub, etc. So you shouldn't. Skills are also mentioned, courses, programming competitions. So this is the basic structure I would like you to follow so that you don't miss out on anything. Okay. Next is add what recruiters wish to see. So for SDE profile like software development engineer, software engineer, IT engineer, if you are talking for CSIT related profile, they wish to see your performance on top coding platforms like CodeChef, CodeForces, LeetCode, etc. So these are the few keywords. As you can see, it must be mentioned in almost all resume. Like in this you will see he has solved more than 300 problems on these platforms and different competitions, and this guy also. Okay, so this is has become the bare minimum. The recruiters are looking for some keywords, whether you like coding or not. But if you want a software engineering job, you have to do at least some basics. At least DSA on LeetCode is mandatory. Okay, coding is not optional but mandatory. Solve 100 plus questions on this and do mention in your resume with links to profile. Like this guy has mentioned, this standardized solved more than 300 questions on CodeChef and added links to his profile, and this Anshul also. Okay, all the links are mentioned here. So what more you can do, like 100 plus 200, but this has become a common thing. You can like, I have solved 50 plus questions specifically in trees or dynamic programming or greedy algorithm or something specific, so that you can make your line stand out, make your resume stand out. You can say I have solved around 50 questions on dynamic programming or LeetCode or CodeChef anywhere. So that's also you can apply. Practical experience in the form of internships, technical preferred. If none available, it's fine. Even unpaid non-technical internships will help. Okay, so if you look at the profile of these guys, he has a lot of technical internships. Okay, he also has technical internships experience, so not an issue with this guy. But in case if you don't have any technical internship, you can add any unpaid or non-tech, some campus ambassador, some community manager. So that's also fine. Okay, because it's better to have something than keeping it empty. You can also add some not-for-profit work you have been part of, like creating awareness about COVID, mask sharing, providing food to the needy, clothes, etc. So blood donation, etc. You can definitely add that. Okay. Next is how to describe projects professionally. Projects with just title seems they are fake. Student have just added without doing any actual work. So first step is you have to add proper title. Like let's look at few example. Block karo. So this is block karo might be a very common thing, but this guy has mentioned sentiment analysis or users block. So it gives you the context in which this thing is working. Restore eats restaurant based web app. So this is the way you have to define your projects. Crop price prediction, data science intern. Okay, PI assistant. Okay, so this is how you define. Let's look at Anshul's, like Melodix music player app, portfolio generator template. Okay, so this is the way you have to follow these things. Write the title of your project professionally with complete details. Okay, instead of just giving the name like restaurant app or library management system, something like. Next is to add a feature description in 3 to 4 line defining what you have made in it, like made a model to detect sentiment, processing to help, worked on backend size to client user inter functional. Okay, so he's also like time series data, made in Python, digital assistant. So all this description is needed, because if you look at this project, you will realize like this guy has definitely done something. But if it is just the name is written, you might feel like it's just added, it's not actually being done by the guy. So make sure you define it in 3 to 4 simple lines. Also add link to live project or GitHub code or just a screenshot hosted on project. So this guy hasn't mentioned it, but Anshul has mentioned. So you must also mention all the GitHub links, or if it is live or anywhere you will like to redirect the project of that specific project. Okay, so these are the four things: title proper, like you have to describe projects properly, have a proper title, detailed feature description in 3 to 4 lines, not details, some brief tools and technology mentioned, and links to the live project that recruiter can just check. Now about design, not jazzy but elegant design. As you can see, all this design are not very out of the box. These are simple design, simple font, simple colors. Okay, so this is what is lucrative for recruiters. Instead of making it jazzy, some bright color or some dark font, that's not gonna work. Don't use contrasting or bright colors. Okay, use simple colors, not more than two. Okay, use only one or two font like Calibri, Times Now, Roman, Arial. So these are the standard form. At best, don't use more than two fonts. You might use a different font like in date and etc. But largely it is only two fonts. Okay. Font size should be consistent, 16 or 18 for heading and 13 to 14 for text. So if you are making a single page resume, then it's also much needed. Also, it doesn't matter. Single page resume are preferred. I have no. Almost everyone makes single page, but even if you make two page, it won't matter. Okay, but make sure you add only things which are relevant. Don't just add for the sake of adding. If something is relevant and it's taking your resume beyond one page, it's not an issue, but it should be relevant. Proper spacing is needing, formatting. Okay, so all these things you have to keep in mind. So you can also use some online tool to make a resume, but standard thing can be easily made with Microsoft Word or Google Word or whatever platform you are using. You don't need some heavy tools or some paid tools. Okay, you can just make it simply. As you can see, all these resumes are simple formatting, nothing out of the box is done or needed. Okay, so you can just make it on your own. So other considerations, some things to keep in mind. I see a lot of students sending your resume in doc format like Word format. Don't always only form send in PDF format. Okay, like all these resumes are in PDF only, never send in doc. Okay, it's really bad impression. Name it properly like achinte_hbt or resume, not like resume.pdf, resume final, resume Monday, resume Tuesday. So don't name it like that. Name it with your name like Harshit Singh underscore your college at best, because you are getting hired on the reference of your college, AKTU, whatever university you would like to mention. So name it properly. You may mention at least two professional references, like you can add some reference to your college HOD, some professor of your college, and second, you can add reference to some professional that you know, because it's relevant when you are applying offline or off campus. So they would like to cross check if you mention a good college. So they would like to cross check whether this guy is really from that college or not. So you have to mention resume, but it's not mandatory, it's optional. Only add anything that you can prove by giving authentic certificate. Never lie about anything. You might think they won't find it, but they may find it, they may not find it, but the risk of getting caught is much higher than advantages of not getting caught. So it's better to not get caught, not take risk in this kind of thing. Just add what is truly you know. Do not add more than 2-3 training and courses, like there are lots of certificates, around 10-15 certificate you will collect. Just select 2 or 3 top most certificate that you think have most value, and 2 or 3 trainings that you think you have done good, and add them only. Okay, so don't fill it like 10 to 12 certificates. So these are the standard things. Okay, you can just go through the video again and look at the example. Let me explain it again, some of the examples. This guy got selected in Amazon. This is his college resume, so you can get an idea of what is required to get in some good company. So simple line describing its interest. He is an electronics engineer who is an interest in algorithms, not an issue. So he has given his date of birth, phone number, LinkedIn and different profiles directly. Technical skills are mentioned. He has mentioned so many skills, you don't have to mention all of them. You can just mention 3 to 4 lines of it. Okay, certification, he has mentioned which one he has taken and a link to it so that a recruiter can check it. Position of responsibility, he has taken some responsibility, so this is a good way of demonstrating it under a separate category. Some achievements, what he have achieved, some projects and everything. Okay, so you can also add something like that. The most important is his experience. He has done some internship, described it what he had done, another internship he has described what he had done. So all these things really help in getting shortlisted. Education, he has done his college and schools in a proper format. Projects he has mentioned, and with proper detail. Okay, this is another resume of a guy who got selected in a data science company fresh out of college. So you can look at how he has done. He has mentioned some internships and project. Okay, properly describe them with links to the code. Okay, so that people can verify. Skills has been mentioned in a limited way. You can also do it like this, as this guy has done. Some courses he has mentioned. So he has mentioned only three. Okay, so that's what I have recommended you to use, 2 to 3. And he has added some specific skills to data science profile. And if you are looking for some specific profile like web development, Android, then you can go deeper into the skill set. Okay. Positions of responsibility is also added. So you, I have told you, you can add any extracurricular thing. You are coordinated, managed. Okay, so it will definitely boost your profile. Data science and programming competitions. So he has also added about his coding profile. Okay, at different platforms, Kaggle is there for data science. So if you are for data science, so you have to definitely be good at Kaggle platform. Okay, so additional details you can also provide if you have something to add. So this is a standard way to make a resume more attractive. I hope our video helped you. If you have any doubts, you can ask us in comments in the section video below.